everyone, and welcome to Maple Leaf ESL. My name is Andrew, and thank you for joining me here today. For today's lesson, I want to take a look at slang expressions that begin with the letter N. So for today's lesson, I've selected 10 different expressions, and we're going to look at definitions, and as always, many examples. Okay, so let's see if we can get started here. So the first one is a verb, and it says nail something, okay? And the definition is to do something perfectly. Okay, we can use this in a lot of different situations, okay? It's any time that you do something perfectly, okay? So if you have to make a presentation and you do the presentation perfectly, you can say, I nailed that presentation, or just, I nailed it, okay? Again, if you're playing sports, right, it could be any sport, and you do something perfectly, right? Like if it's baseball, if you throw the ball perfectly, or if it's basketball, maybe you shoot it or pass it perfectly, you can say, I nailed it, right? I nailed that shot, or I nailed that throw. So anything that you do perfectly, right? You could be playing a video game, and maybe you did this sort of move in the video game that was perfect. So you can say, I nailed it. Okay, next one, also a verb. It says to nail someone, and the definition says to catch or bust someone doing something wrong, okay? All right, imagine. Two guys are robbing a bank, and then the police come and they catch them robbing the bank. So we can say the police nailed those two robbers, right? They nailed those guys. That means they caught them or they busted them committing this crime, right? Or again, maybe every day I notice that somebody is taking my lunch out of the fridge at work, okay? So now today I wait. And then I see the person go over to the fridge and I see them take my lunch. So I nailed that person, right? I busted them or I caught them doing this bad thing, right? Doing this wrong thing, okay? So that's how we use that one. Okay, next one is a noun and it says a no-brainer, okay? And it says something easy that has an obvious solution or answer. Okay, this is a great expression, okay? Imagine somebody offers you $1 million and they say, no, that's it. There's no, you don't have to pay me back, right? There's no condition here. I'm just gonna give you $1 million for free. So should you accept it? Of course you should, right? It's a no-brainer, right? You don't need to think about that. That has an obvious answer, right? Or a clear answer, right? Of course you're gonna say yes. Okay, or imagine your girlfriend or your boyfriend is really angry at you, maybe because you lied to them, okay? So how can you fix this? Well, you could apologize, right? That's a no-brainer, right? So apologizing in this situation is a no-brainer, right? It is the obvious solution. Okay, next one is a verb, and it says they're nix, and the definition is to cancel or stop something. Okay, if my boss nixes the meeting, that means he has canceled the meeting. Okay, or if I have an idea for a project, but then the manager nixes my idea for the project, so again, the manager has canceled my idea for this project. So anytime something is nixed, we're gonna say it's canceled, right? If the concert is nixed, that means it's been canceled, right? If today's sports game, like maybe the baseball game is canceled because it's raining or the weather is bad, we can say the game was nixed, right? So the game was canceled. Okay, next one is a noun, and it says here a no-no. And the definition is something that you shouldn't do, okay? So usually for this, we think about rules, right? Okay, so for example, maybe in my office, we're not allowed to wear jeans, right? Like denim. Or we're not allowed to wear sandals. So then I can say, in my office, wearing jeans is a no-no. Or wearing sandals is a no-no. Okay, or maybe in my apartment building, right? If I live in an apartment, maybe there's no pets allowed in the apartment. So pets are a no-no. Okay? Or maybe if I go to a restaurant and we can't smoke in this restaurant, right? That's kind of the rule of the restaurant. Then we can say smoking is a no-no, right? So anytime when you shouldn't do something, again, think about it like a rule, like the rule is that you shouldn't do this, then you can say something is a no-no, right? Smoking is a no-no in this building. Okay, next one is an adjective, and it says they're nuts. And the definition is crazy or insane. Okay, I can use this one to talk about a person, or I can use it to talk about a situation. So if one of my friends is acting pretty crazy, I can say he's acting nuts or he's nuts. Or if I'm in a situation that is very strange, maybe it's sort of an unbelievable situation, I can say this is nuts. Or this situation is nuts, right? So often you see this in movies where people are just in crazy situations and you can say, wow, that is nuts, okay? All right, next one is a verb and it says they're narc. And the definition is to tell the police or other authorities about illegal or bad activities. Okay, and just, it says they're authorities, right? So an authority is anybody who's in charge. So an authority could be a parent, or it could be a teacher, or it could be a boss or a manager or something like that, or it could be the police, okay? So if we think about, if you narc on someone, that means you tell the police or you tell the teacher about the bad thing they did. So if my friend steals something from a store and then I go tell the store owner or I go tell the police, then I narked on my friend, okay? Or imagine my sister does something, right? Maybe I'm young, think about if I'm a kid and my sister says some bad words. So I go tell my mom, Mom, my sister said some bad words, right? So I narked on my sister, right? So again, I told the authorities, and in this situation, the authorities means our parents, right? So again, it could be the teacher, right? If one of the classmates in my class is cheating and then I tell the teacher, hey, this guy's cheating, then I narked on this guy, right? So that's how we use that one. Okay, a few more to go here. So we've got another verb and it says nitpick. And the definition is to complain about or be too concerned about small problems. Okay, so let's imagine I always cook for my girlfriend, okay? I cook her meals, but she always complains like, oh, there's too much salt, or maybe you overcooked the chicken, or there's too much sauce. So she's always got a little complaint about my cooking. So we can say that she nitpicks about my cooking, right? So she's complaining about little tiny things. Okay, or maybe I write an email to my friend and maybe I have some small little spelling mistakes, but it's not really important, right? The message is still clear. But maybe my friend says, oh, you spelled this wrong, or did you mean this? So he's kind of complaining about my little problems, my little mistakes, or he's too concerned about my little mistakes, so he's nitpicking about my writing or about my email. Okay, and also, a person who nitpicks, we can call that person a nitpicker. So that's a noun, right? A person who nitpicks is a nitpicker. Okay, next one says no sweat, and it says there the definition is no problem or no worries. Okay, so all three of those expressions are the same, right? If I say thank you for helping me, then the other person can say no problem. Or they could say no worries or no sweat, right? Thanks for the help, no sweat. So that kind of means you're welcome, or it means like no problem, right? So that's how we use that one. It's just a phrase that we use to mean no problem or you're welcome. Okay, and last one is a noun, and it says they're a no-show, okay? And the definition is a person who doesn't come to an event, meeting, or an appointment, and it says there, and without calling. Okay, imagine I have an appointment at the doctor, right? Or maybe at the dentist, but maybe I forgot about it, or maybe I was too busy and I didn't go to this appointment. So you can say that I was a no-show at the doctor. Okay, or imagine there's a meeting at my office and one guy, let's say James, he didn't come to the meeting, right? And he didn't tell anybody. He didn't call us and tell us he's not coming. He didn't send an email. So James was a no-show, right? He didn't come to the meeting. Or again, imagine I'm having a party, right? That's an event. I'm having a party and I invited a bunch of friends, but one of my friends didn't come. And she didn't call me and tell me she wasn't coming. She didn't send me a message. So she was a no-show, right? So we can use that anytime somebody doesn't come to an event or a meeting, but they said they were gonna come, right? We thought they were coming. Okay, I'm going to erase the whiteboard and let's see if we can take a look at some written examples using each of these slang expressions. All right then, so let's see if we can take a look at some of these examples. So the first one there says, I totally nailed that test, right? So that means I did really well, right? Or maybe perfectly on that test. Okay, next one. Did you hear that the police nailed those two bank robbers, right? So the police caught those two bank robbers, or they busted those bank robbers. Okay, next one. Which TV are you going to buy? That's a no-brainer. The Samsung is bigger and half the cost, right? So again, you know, if one is clearly it's much cheaper but just as good, then it's a no-brainer, right? Okay, next one. Too bad the boss nixed your idea. I thought it was great, right? So the boss said no to your idea, right? He kind of canceled your idea. Okay, next one. Smoking inside the school is a no-no, right? So smoking's not allowed in the school. It's against the rules, okay? You're going camping in the snow? What are you, nuts, right? Are you crazy? Are you insane? Okay, next one. I used to get free internet in my apartment until the neighbors narked on me, right? So the neighbors told the police, or they told the internet provider. Okay, next one. She's always nitpicking over unimportant details. So she's always very concerned about these little small details that are not important. Okay, couple more. Next one says, thanks for helping me study for the test. No sweat, right? No problem, or you're welcome. Okay, and last one. Work was so busy today, two of our salespeople were no-shows, right? So two of the salespeople didn't come to the office today, so we were really busy. Okay, that is the end of today's lesson. I hope these examples were clear and easy to follow. Thanks so much for joining me here today at Maple Leaf ESL, and we will see you again next time.